This is a circle with radius 1, so the length of the circumference is tau. The method we're using here to approximate tau is to inscribe and circumscribe two polygons around the circle, and the lengths of the polygon's perimeters will approach the length of the circumference as we increase the number of sides. This method is known as the method of exhaustion or Archimedes method. Let's first draw an inscribed hexagon. The circumradius is 1, so the side length is also 1. We use the notation I6 to represent the side length of the inscribed hexagon. Let's generalize this length and call it IN, where N is the number of sides. Let's draw a line from the center of the circle to one of the endpoints. It is also a radius, so its length is 1. This length is half of the polygon side, so its length is IN over 2. Using the Pythagorean theorem, we can find the length of the polygon's apothem. This length together with the apothem forms a radius, so its length is 1 minus the length of the apothem. Using the Pythagorean theorem, we can calculate this length, and by simplifying it, we find this length to be the square root of 2 minus the square root of 4 minus IN squared. This line is also a side of an inscribed 2N gon, so it can be written as I2N. This is a circumscribed hexagon, its apothem is also a radius, so its length is 1. Using the ratio of a 30-60-90 triangle sides, we can find the side length of this hexagon to be 2 times the square root of 3 all over 3. We use the notation C6 to represent the side length of the circumscribed hexagon. Let's generalize this hexagon to be a circumscribed n-gon and draw a circumscribed 2n-gon, where its side length is C2n by definition. This line is a side of the inscribed n-gon, so its length is IN. This line is a side of the circumscribed 2n-gon, so if we have it, we get C2n over 2. This line is a side of the circumscribed n-gon, so if we have it, we get Cn over 2. This triangle and this triangle are both isosceles and share the same angle at their apexes, so they are similar, and their relation can be expressed as two equal ratios. After simplifying the equation, we get the formula for finding C2n. Because the inscribed polygon's perimeter is less than the circumference is less than the circumscribed polygon's perimeter, we can express this relation by this inequality. Let's try using this method to approximate tau to the second digit after decimal. The perimeters of the polygons match up to two decimal places when we reach n equals 96. We can thus conclude that tau must be approximately equal to 6.28. This animation is completely made in Manim. Manim is a Python library that lets you create beautiful mathematical animations using only Python code. If you want to try it out for yourself, go to the link shown on screen or in the description down below. The voiceover was done using Manim VoiceOver, which is a Python library that lets you use AI-generated voice in your Manim videos. Check the link in the description to try it out yourself.